Yeah, all of you. Yeah, look.
So name it dal dena.
One second, hold on.
One second, hold on.
एक मिनट वेट.
यस थैंक यू. सिर्फ अभी ओनली स्टार का सेंटर लो. सेंटर लो.
डन.
Thank you.
Look camera.
One second, hold on. भाई बोला
सबसे पहले तो स्टिल अबाउट सेक्शन 377 उससे पहले जो पार्ट आया था लोगों ने सबने देखा है बहुत ज्यादा एप्रिसिएशन मिला है. क्या कहना चाहेंगे ये पार्ट में क्या उससे अलग होने वाला है और ऑलरेडी सेक्शन 377 तो पास हो चुका है क्या कहेंगे इस बारे में.
मैं यही कहना चाहूँगा कि जो हमारा पहला सीज़न था ऑल अबाउट सेक्शन 377 उसको बहुत ज़्यादा अप्रिसिएशन मिली थी. वो 2016 में रिलीज़ हुआ था और इस बार हम लोग ला रहे हैं उसका एक्सटेंशन जिसका नाम है स्टिल अबाउट सेक्शन 377. ये स्टोरी है एक गे कपल की जो विलेज में जा पहुँचते हैं उनमें से किसी एक फैमिली की एक्सेप्टेंस की तलाश में. और इस वेब सीरीज़ में पहली बार हम एक ट्रांसजेंडर का स्ट्रगल भी दर्शा रहे हैं एंड वी आर ट्राइंग टू हाईलाइट व्हाट ऑल दे हैव टू गो थ्रू टू बी एक्सेप्टेड इन सोसाइटी. तो ये बेसिक वन लाइनर है हमारे शो का और मैं बहुत ज़्यादा खुश हूँ कि गवर्नमेंट ने सेक्शन 377 के कुछ पार्ट्स अनकॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल कर दिए हैं और ये बहुत ही लिबरेटिंग फीलिंग है. ये बहुत ही खुशी की बात है क्योंकि वी आर मूविंग टूवर्ड्स अ मोर इंक्लूसिव इंडिया जहाँ पे सब किसी से भी प्यार कर सकते हैं, उन्हें किसी से घबराने या डरने की जरूरत नहीं है.
एज अ कैप्टन ऑफ द शिप जहाँ पे आपने शूट किया था वहाँ पे मतलब किस तरह से शूट करने मिला आप लोगों को, क्योंकि इस बारे में स्पेशली गांव में कोई बात नहीं करना चाहता इस बारे में, तो एज अ कैप्टन ऑफ द शिप क्या चैलेंजेस फेस करने पड़े आपको?
एक्चुअली सेक्शन स्टिल अबाउट सेक्शन 377 हमने जटखोर नाम के गाँव में शूट किया है जो एक्चुअली गुलशन का गाँव है जो हमारे वेब सीरीज़ में लीड कैरेक्टर भी प्ले कर रहे हैं. और हमें शूटिंग के दौरान तो कोई दिक्कत नहीं हुई बट उसको शूट लाइक टू गेट टू द स्टेज ऑफ शूटिंग वाज अ बिग चैलेंज क्योंकि पहले तो सेक्शन 377 था और बहुत प्रोड्यूसर्स फाइनेंसर्स घबराते थे इनसे इस काइंड ऑफ टॉपिक से जुड़ने में, तो फाइनेंस का प्रॉब्लम हो रहा था. पर फिर हमारे साथ बहुत अच्छे प्रोड्यूसर्स जुड़े जैसे कि डांसिंग शिवा फिल्म मेकर्स, आसमी एंटरटेनमेंट, SP सिनेकॉर्प, तो बहुत सारे लोग जुड़ के आए आगे और उन्होंने मिल के हमें बहुत ही इंकरेज किया ये शो बनाने के लिए. और गांव में तो हमें बहुत मज़ा आता था एक्चुअली क्योंकि बहुत ही ज़्यादा खूबसूरत गांव था, सिर्फ थोड़े बच्चे हमें तंग करते थे उसके अलावा हाँ चिल्ला के उन लोग भाग जाते थे पर एक्चुअली अदरवाइज हमें कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं हुई. मैं बहुत खुश था वहाँ पे शूट करने के लिए क्योंकि उन लोगों के बहुत क्वेश्चंस आते थे. वो आके मुझे पूछते थे ये वो है ना, ये वैसे है ना, तो उनको समझाता था मैं कभी कभी जब भी मेरे पास टाइम होता था, नहीं होता था तो फिर मैं भाग जाता था वहाँ से. बट एनीवेज मैं बहुत खुश था क्योंकि थोड़े और लोगों को हमारे इमोशनल जर्नी के बारे में हम थोड़ा और एक्सप्लेन कर सके.
एक्टर्स से जानना चाहूंगा अपने किरदार के बारे में बताइए और कैसा रहा जर्नी, जैसे सर ने कहा कि बहुत ही अच्छा जर्नी था जहाँ पे आपने शूट किया, तो सबसे पहले किरदार के बारे में बात करते हैं, उसके बाद एक्सपीरियंस रहा इस जर्नी का, आपसे शुरुआत करते हैं.
मेरा तो जैसे फर्स्ट सीजन था ऑल अबाउट सेक्शन 377 में, उसमें तो मेरी ही थिंकिंग खुद की ही चेंज हुई थी. मैं ही होमोफोबिक था तो मैं ही उनके खिलाफ था, तो मेरा परसेप्शन उसमें चेंज हुआ. अब भी सेकेंड सीजन में मैं रोहित और सिड के साथ हूँ तो मैं सिड को लेने जाता हूँ रोहित के साथ गांव में, तो ये
कैरेक्टर को लेके बिल्कुल चेंजेस थे बहुत सारे, क्योंकि पहले जो कैरेक्टर था जो मैंने सेक्शन 377 में प्ले किया था सीज़न वन में, ऑल अबाउट सेक्शन 377 में, तो वहाँ से बहुत कुछ सीखने को मिला था। बट एज एन एक्टर वो मेरा पहला प्रोजेक्ट था, उससे पहले मैंने कुछ काम किया नहीं था। और उसके बाद स्टिल अबाउट सेक्शन 377 में हमें बीच में एक साल मिला, बहुत टाइम मिला कैरेक्टर को समझने में, जो कि अमित ने समझाया, और तो उससे बहुत ईजी हो गया था जो भी उसे प्ले करने के लिए।
मेरा जो कैरेक्टर है वो सेठ के अंकल का कैरेक्टर है, और काफ़ी इंटरेस्टिंग कैरेक्टर है, बिकॉज जो बात अमित ने बताई कि जिसमें हाईलाइट किया गया है वो रूरल एरियाज़ में जो है, तो वहाँ पे क्या है कि इस टाइप की चीज़ों को समझा ही नहीं जाता है। तो जो ये मेरा कैरेक्टर है वो वही है कि वो खुद में अंदर घुट रहा है कि जो अपनी फाइट है कि उस चीज़ को दूसरों तक बताने की, तो बेसिकली उस चीज़ को पोर्ट्रे कर रहे हैं कि किस तरीके से वो फ्रस्ट्रेटेड है कि उसको कुछ समझ नहीं रहे हैं लोग, और वो अपनी लाइफ में खुश हैं लेकिन शायद कोई ये नहीं जानना चाहता कि उसकी लाइफ में क्या चल रहा है।
एक्टर लोगों से मैं और एक चीज़ जानना चाहूँगा कि आप लोगों ने जब शुरुआत की थी जब फर्स्ट सीजन की, और अब जब सेकेंड सीजन आ चुका है, आप लोगों में क्या चेंजेस देख रहे हैं और खुद में क्या चेंजेस देख रहे हैं? हालांकि जब आपने स्टार्ट किया होगा तभी आपने सोचा होगा कि कुछ नया टॉपिक है, लोग एक्सेप्ट करेंगे या नहीं करेंगे, तो उस ऐसी कोई थिंकिंग चल रही थी आपके दिल में, अगर कुछ शेयर करना चाहे आप लोग?
जब एक्चुअली स्टार्ट किया तब तो सोचा ही नहीं था कि इतना बड़ा हो जाएगा, हमने तो ऐसे बैठे बैठे एक रूम में सोच लिया था कि बना लेते हैं, तो ऐसे ही बन गया था। बट अभी लोगों की थिंकिंग तो चेंज हो रही है ऑब्वियसली, अभी रूल भी आ गया है तो सेक्शन 377 भी हट गया है, तो अभी होपफुली अभी अवेयरनेस की ही है, और बस जितना अवेयरनेस हो जाए उतना अच्छा है, और हमारी सीरीज के थ्रू हो रहा है।
मुझे लगता है कि जब पहले हमने जब ये सीरीज़ बनाई थी तो उस समय मुझे ज़्यादा नॉलेज नहीं थी इस चीज़ के बारे में, मतलब कि सेक्शन 377 के बारे में मुझे कुछ पता नहीं था। बट एज एन एक्टर मेरे को एक अपॉर्चुनिटी मिली और मुझे वो करना था और मैंने किया। पर जब दूसरी बार अभी किया तो बहुत कुछ सीखने को मिला। पर जैसे आपका क्वेश्चन है कि एक्सेप्टेंस के लिए, मुझे लगता है कि अभी लोगों को एक्सेप्ट करना ज़रूरी है। अभी तक बहुत सारे मतलब आई वुड से कि 50% लोग ऐसे होंगे कम से कम जिन्होंने एक्सेप्ट नहीं किया है, कि हालांकि लॉ हट चुका है वो, पर लोगों के लिए बहुत ज़रूरी है उस एक्सेप्ट करना।
Okay, really good to see everyone on the on board. You know, I mean, the moment you started or the day you started, now you are coming with another. I would say it would be a sequel. What you have done in the past.
Yes.
Something absolutely different. You know, are you nervous or there'll be a sense of responsibility when you're coming with another product? the last one, the past one is appreciated by everyone. You know, when I talk about Section 377, now you are coming with another version of it,
yeah,
where you're discussing transgender's life. So. Do you think there's a sense of responsibility, and what is the preparation you have done while working on this project?
Well, obviously there is a huge sense of responsibility because I'm presenting a topic to the society which they need to address. It's informative. I need to make sure that it's informative as well as entertaining and emotional at the same time. A lot of research went into writing the second season. It almost took me 1.5 years to write it because I was actually not aware about the struggles that the transgender community faces in India. For that, Humsafar Trust actually helped me a lot. They gave me some presentations to go through, a lot of study material to read. And that was all practical, but it was also very important for me to understand the emotional graph that a transgender goes through, especially in a rural setup, in a small village. So it took me a lot of time to write this show because I didn't want to go wrong. I didn't want the audience to feel cheated, or I didn't want to break their trust that they have shown in the first season, because I wanted to give them information that is correct so that they know what is happening in society and that they can kind of be a part of the change that we all want. We want the country to accept everybody just as the way they are, because even though Section 377 has been struck down, I feel that there is a long way for the LGBTQ community to further cross, and social acceptance happens to be the first of it. And I feel that our show is a step forward in that direction, and it is a huge responsibility because that is the way I can create value at my place of work. We all can do that in our own little ways, and this was what I could do as a writer, as a director, and probably as an actor as well. Yeah.
Okay, the moment I want to take it on a positive note, or I would say rather a writer note, the moment I saw you, this is the very first time I'm interacting with you as a journalist, you remind me of Karan Johar, the way you talk, the way you carry yourself, you know. Don't you wish Karan Johar support your film, your project?
Well, everybody wishes, I think anybody making any kind of film or content will wish that Karan Johar supports it. Even if it was not LGBTQ or even if it was not, I think because that is one of the biggest production houses that we have. But I would take it as a compliment because I actually love him, because he has really, really done so much, and he's changing and breaking so many myths that I think that it's a big compliment for someone like me. So yeah, I hope that my bank balance in a few years also reminds you of him.
Okay. Apart from this, I've also you know, seen inside Audi, you're talking about Blue, another app which is absolutely something very new we have never seen. We have seen numerous apps which talks about music, you know, there's so many things. Whose idea is this to get Blue on board, or Blue came on board, or Blue asked you people to come on board? Tell us about the app, and it is absolutely something very, you know, I would say it's a new, unique thing, you know.
Well, absolutely. It's a great thing because you can meet people of the similar sexual orientation as you are. So I think talking about the app, we have you know, a lot of representation from Blue, and I think they should be the ones answering this question. So yeah.
Yeah. Basically, I think as I'm a foreigner, and I know this episode in September, and I feel like because I'm the country manager of Blue in India. So once I noticed this episode, and I think this is one of the most popular episode in this country, and related to the LGBTQ content. So I think Blue as one of the largest gay social app in the world, and I think it's a perfect match for both of us to collaborate together. So that's why I contact with Danshi Shiva, and so yeah, we move forward for this collaboration.
Okay.
So when we speak about content into LGBTQ you know, kind of content, so there are less of production houses which kind of offer this platform, offer this kind of content to across like India, and it's not still mainstream. And Amit, having this series which was already popular, so we had kind of a same sort of campaign which was going on. It was towards what's next 377. As you see, the storyline is all about like a urban gay couple which lands into a village, and then they are having the pressure of their family, and due to that they find all those complications. The same kind of complications is very much relatable to the LGBTQ people in India. And we speak about Blue being a partner with such a series. We had this thought into mind that we definitely want to support such content which has strong values to put into society. Because it's not only about a section getting scraped off, but to change the mindsets of people of India. That acceptance is still an integral part of a person who's gay or who's bi or who's of any kind of sexuality. So as the character into the series goes into the dilemma, and due to the family pressure, he is going to get married. Similar to that, there are a lot of people who live inside the closet, and they eventually get married to people of opposite sex. Blued as a platform believes into creating a very safe and secure platform where people can not only date, but it's kind of an entire social network. So that's how Blued wants to present such content and support such kind of content. And we definitely will be having much more kind of campaigns in future, or to collaborate with such kind of talent in near future. So that's what Blued is going to do.
Okay, lastly, when it will be releasing, and which platform you are releasing this?
Well, it's releasing as we speak now. So when, you know, this video is going to come on air, probably the show would have released. So right now it's releasing on the YouTube channel Dancing Shiva, as well as the Facebook page by the same name, which is called Dancing Shiva. It's available from 3 o'clock onwards today, which is the 3rd of December 2018. Well, we also it had released. The first episode has come out on the 9th of September, and from today onwards you can watch the entire season on the Dancing Shiva channel on YouTube.
So as I said, that the content, the kind of content we see into, we don't see such kind of content mainstream on televisions or something like that. Web series is quite, you know, mainstream and very much relatable to a lot of audience nowadays. And especially if we talk about youth, and that's how you try to change the perception of society. And it was already a popular series, as I said. So Blue Twin came onto board. We had already one campaign which was around What's Next 377. And the entire series is also about, still about Section 377. So it's, we kind of thought that it's quite a next part what we expect from LGBTQ people. So what do they exactly want? So it's not more than about having a having dates or finding a dating partner, but it's more about certain rights which matter to people from the community. It may be same-sex marriage, it can be right to adoption, and different, you know, factors which involve into that. So Blued has all of those kind of features and kind of platform where it's not only about dating, but kind of socializing and finding people who are from the community and cater to most of the integral issues which we have right now in India.
And how does the Blued app look towards the Indian market? You know, what's your strategy to get into the Indian market?
Okay. So when we speak about India, it's quite diverse. It has a lot of regional languages, it has different skin tones and sexualities, and altogether it's a diverse kind of a country. And to tap into that diversification of individual person from the community is quite difficult. So what we are thinking and how we are studying the market is towards the diversification of the community. We are trying to study the kind of patterns, how the LGBT population of India, you know, what do they want, what kind of features we should bring into the application, which is much more about dating. So we have a feature called live streaming, where, like, you know, talent can grow up anywhere. It can be in a small remote village. So we have live stream as a feature where anybody can just sit on, use their phone and go live stream, and they would be visible to the masses. And that's how we want to bring the talent out of LGBT community from India. And again, they can be as popular as these guys are.
So coming back to the series, could you tell us what's the story of this series, and whether is it a direct relation to the first series?
Well, you can watch still about Section 377 very independently. You do need not watch the first season in order to watch the second season. But if you've watched the first season, you will probably understand the second season a little bit more deeper. That's what I would like to say. The story of still about Section 377 is primarily about an urban couple landing up in a village in order to look for acceptance by one of the partner's family. We also have a strong transgender track that highlights the struggles that a transgender faces in a rural setup.